indecision that caused Pontius Pilate not to do what we know that is truth. So today, our teaching today is about Peter's fall from grace, a warning to all believers. Amen? Peter fall from grace, a warning to all believers. The text we will consider today is Matthew chapter 26. You can write it down. Matthew chapter 26, verse 57 to 75. Mark chapter 14, verse 66 to 72. I repeat, Mark chapter 14, verse 66 to 72. John chapter 18, verse 27. John chapter 18, verse 27. Romans 11, verse 20. Romans 11, verse 20. 1 Corinthians, verse 10. Chapter 10, verse 12. 1 Corinthians, chapter 10, verse 12. Amen? I hope that you have written it down. Teaching objective: visiting Peter's great spiritual experience and achievement. Visiting Peter's great spiritual experience and achievement. Number two, identifying the steps involved in Peter's backsliding. Identifying the steps involved in Peter's backsliding. Amen?
Amen.
So, that is the objective. Then, let us look into Peter's spiritual experience and achievement. I have here 9 points. I'm going to read it out, and some of the verses, you may just write them down. Amen? In Peter's fall, we observe there is no level of Christianity. I mean, there is no level you and I will attain. We say, yes, we have arrived. We can only arrive when we see God face to face. Amen? So here is Peter's achievement. Peter was truly converted. We can see that in Matthew chapter 19, verse 27. Number two, he's an apostle of Jesus. Amen? That's number two achievement. We can see that in the book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 14 to 42. Amen. Number three, he preached the word. Peter preached the word of God. He preached the word of God with power. We can see that in the book of Acts. He preached the word of God. That was in Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2, verse 14 to 42. Then number 4, Peter did miracles. When Peter preached, many souls were won. The cripple rise up and walk. We can see that in Acts chapter 3, verse 6 to 9. Peter walked on water with Christ. We can see that in Matthew chapter 14 to verse 28 to 29. Number 6. He saw spectacular miracles did by Jesus. We can see that in Matthew chapter 14, verse 13 to 21. He was there at Mountains of Transfiguration. Not all the apostles Jesus took to a Mountain of Transfiguration. We can see that in Matthew chapter 17, verse 1 to 4. Number 8. Peter made a great confession great confession of Christ by divine revelation. We can also see that in Matthew chapter 16. Then number 9, a member of Christ's inner circle. We can see that in Matthew 17, verse 1. Peter partook in Lord's Last Supper. Amen? So we can see that in Luke chapter 22, verse 7 to 20. So these are Peter's great divine achievements. Despite all these achievements, Peter also have a weakness. Amen? So the memory verse of our teaching today is 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 12. I read, Wherefore, let him that taketh his standard take heed, lest he fall. Amen? So that means that you think that you know everything about God. You think that you know in and out about God. You think that you have arrived. The Bible says you should be humble. Amen? Yeah. The Bible says you and I should be humble. Because when we start to raise our shoulder, hey, I am strong. Glory be to God that you are strong. But the word of God says you should be humble. Amen? As we proceed, we will also see Peter's shortcoming. Because of, he thought that he had arrived, but yet he still had a very long way to go. Amen? So, before a child of God backslide, there are many steps that lead to, that brother was a man of God. How come? Oh, that sister was a woman of God. Just look at her. Look at the way she's living now. You know? If you will recall back, there are many steps that lead to a great fall. I have witnessed when a man of God backslided. There are many steps. So now, we will now focus on Peter's steps, how he fell and fall from grace. Amen? Yeah. Number one, identifying the steps that leads to Peter's fall from grace. Peter was boastful. He boasted in self-confidence that he would never deny Christ, even the point of death. But first of all, let us read the disembodiment text. That is Matthew chapter 26. And I need a fast reader. Because that is the main chapter that will be focused. Matthew chapter 26, verse 57 to 75. Usher, please, can you give some?
Verse, can I
read? Matthew chapter 26, verse 57 to 17. Yes, read, please.
Those who had arrested Jesus took him to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the teachers of the law and the elders had assembled. But Peter followed him at a distance, right up to the courtyard at the high priest, He entered and sat down with the guards to see the outcome. The chief priest and the whole Sanhedrin were looking for false evidence against Jesus so that they could put him to death. But they did not find any, though many false witnesses came forward. Finally, two came forward and decided and declared, "This fellow said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days.'" Then the high priest stood up and said to Jesus, "Are you not going to answer? What is the testimony that this man are bringing against you?" But Jesus remained silent. The high priest said to him, "I charge you under oath by the living God. Tell us you are the Messiah, the Son of God." "You have said so," Jesus replied. "But I say to all of you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "He has spoken blasphemy. Why do we need any more witnesses? Look, now you have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?" "He is worthy of death," they answered. Then they spit in his face and struck him with their fist. Others slapped him and said, "Prophesy to us, Messiah. Who eats you?" Now Peter was sitting out in the courtyard, and a servant girl came to him. "You also were with Jesus of Galilee," she said. But he denied it before them all. "I don't know what you're talking about," he said. Then he went to the gateway where the other servant girl saw him and said to the people there, "This fellow was with Jesus of Nazareth." He denied it again with an oath, "I don't know the man." After a little while, those standing there went up to Peter and said, "Surely you are one of them. Your accent gives you away." Then he began to call down curses and swore to them, "I don't know the man." Immediately a rooster crowed. Then Peter remembered the word Jesus had spoken, "Before the rooster crows, you will disown me 3 times." And he went outside and wept bitterly.
Amen. And the book of Matthew 26, 57, and verse 55, 57 to 75, and Mark 14, 66, verse 66 to 72, is on the same account. So can you also help me read John chapter 18, verse 27? John 18, chapter 27.
It says, "Again, Peter denied it, and at that time, the rooster began to crow."
Amen. And Romans 11, verse 20. Romans 11. 20.
"Granted, but they were broken off because of unbelief, and you stand by faith. Do not be arrogant, but tremble."
Amen. Amen. So now let us take it part by part, identifying the steps that lead to Peter's fall from grace. Number one, he boasted his self-confidence that he will never deny Christ, even at the point of death. You know, when Jesus Christ tell him about denying him, instead of Peter to be humble, he say, you know, he make a boast. I will even die for you, even to point of death. You want to go to prison, I will follow you, Christ. Amen? Are you seeing that? That is boasting. Boasting. So, what message now are we learning from this particular portion of scripture? Today, I may be strong today. Hey, fidelity is strong. Tomorrow, you may see me, you know, in another dimension. So we should serve God in humility and in with humble hearts in every areas of our life. Glory be to God. We are strong today. We can boast in the name of the Lord. Amen?
Yes.
Not in our own strength. We can boast on kneeling down, praying to God. God, help me, oh God. God, keep me away from this temptation. God, keep me from every hour of temptation. God, here is my weakness. Peter did not acknowledge this. It shows that when a man of God talks to you, don't be fast to reply. Don't be fast to, you know, to give an answer. Amen?
Yeah.
Number one, Peter was boastful. So as a child of God, we should not boast. Amen?
Yeah.
Number two, he argued with Christ when one of his coming fall. Instead of humbling himself at Christ's warning, he contradicted with Christ. Christ said will happen. You know, word of God never have any contradiction in our life. We are the one who contradicts the word of God. Amen?
Amen.
We are the one. Word of God is good. Word of God is pure. Word of God is truth. You know, Peter was even privileged for seeing Christ. You know, Christ telling him what is about to happen. Instead, he contradicted himself. Amen?
Amen?
And he said, we must never argue with the word of God, even if it seems contradictory to our situation or our understanding. It is better to forsake anything or anyone that contradicts God's words. You know, sometimes our circumstance may help us to look that the word of God is contradictory, that word of God is not true. Amen?
Amen.
So the picture of Peter is telling us that the word of God is not contradictory. Word of God is true. Word of God is pure. Word of God is right. Word of God is strong, powerful. Amen?
Yes.
Number three. Peter slept instead of obeying Christ's instruction to watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. You know? When a revelation is given to you, you should not neglect that revelation. You're supposed to pray. Like Christ has given Peter, that this is what will happen. But Peter did not pray. Peter did not watch and pray. How does this translate into our life as a child of God? When a pastor or elder pastor give a revelation, or maybe you went to see pastor. Pastor can see you, pastor, this is, and pastor, because as you are talking to pastor, God will also give an instant revelation concerning that circumstance. And when pastor gives you a revelation or tell you that this is what, you know, do this, you should not just ignore it. Go home and pray concerning that revelation. Amen?
Amen?
Because God has already told Peter that this is what will happen. Instead of Peter to watch and pray, Peter will be sleeping. Amen? We can see that in the book of Matthew, chapter 26, 41. Can we read that? Matthew 26, 41. I read, watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed that is willing, but the flesh is weak. Amen? as a child of God, we need to always pray that God will keep us on the hour of temptation. Amen?
Amen.
Number four steps. Peter depends on the arm of the flesh. He used his sword to defend Christ. But spiritual battles are only fought with spiritual weapons, not physical. He and others, disciples, fled. Amen? So, when they came to arrest Jesus Christ, Peter thought that it was a physical fighter. Mm-hmm. Then he brought out his sword and sliced off the ear of one of the soldiers. Can we turn to 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 9? Amen?
Amen.
1 Samuel. Are you there?
He will guard the feet of the faithful servant, but the wicked will be sliced in the place of the darkness.
No.
Well, but the wicked will be silenced in the place of darkness.
Chapter 2, verse 9.
Chapter
2, verse 9.
1
Samuel chapter 2, verse 9.
He will guard the feet of the faith of his faithful servant, but the wicked will be silenced in the place of darkness.
I read. He will keep the feet of his saints, and the wicked shall be silenced in the darkness. For by strength shall no man prevail. Amen?
Amen.
So we should not pray that it's not by strength. Amen. So Peter thought that it was a physical battle. It is not. Amen?
Amen.
It's like that he want to fight physical battle. And can we also read 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3. If you are there, you read. Amen. Even though we walk in the flesh, but we are not fighting in the flesh. Amen? So that is Peter, you know. Let me recall. First, Peter was boastful. Number two, Peter arguing with the word of God. Number three, Peter slept instead of watch and pray. Now, number four, Peter was thinking that what Christ was saying is a physical fighting. You know, even if we walk in flesh, but we don't war with flesh. It is spiritual battle. Amen?
Amen.
Number five, Peter decided to follow Christ afar off in order to see the end. Amen?
Amen.
Well, there were 12 apostles. Where are the rest? Well, Peter tried a bit, you know. The rest fled. They don't want to identify with Christ. But Peter, at least, Peter followed, you know, to see the end. To see the end. Can we read Matthew 26:58? Can we recall that? Matthew 26, verse 58. Amen.
He entered and sat down with the guards to see the outcome.
Amen. You know, there are 2 points here. Peter followed Christ afar, number one. And Peter sitting down with the people, walking to kill, to crucify, to shame, to disgrace Jesus Christ. Today, be following Christ afar by rejecting his word. Today we have friends that sometimes, you know, we are in their midst, they are criticizing your God. They are talking bad against your God. And you are still with them. It is not good. It is not good. So, Peter followed Christ afar to see the end. I pray that the Almighty God will help us not to follow the Almighty God afar. We will see the end of our life in glory with Jesus.
Amen.
We will see our life ending in a victorious way.
Amen.
Because Peter, you know, Peter already knows that at the end of the day we crucify Jesus. There is no way he can able to do it. So he just following the sequence of the pictures. Amen?
Amen.
So, at the slightest recognition of backsliding or lukewarmness in the heart, we should pray to God for help, to help us earlier. Amen?
Amen.
So, it's also a part that contributed to Peter's great fall. Number six, the fear of man. Peter feared what man will do to him if he acknowledged Christ. All of us here have the experience. Yes, all of us here have. We fear men rather than God. Because why? Because we want to benefit from that man. We want to benefit from that woman. But we should recognize that the giver of that man's possession is God. Amen?
Amen?
Even sometimes the person we work for, if it's not a Christian, we are not bold to say, oh, you know, I am a child of God, you know. Oh, please, can I pray? Oh, please, can I, you know, just declare who you are. Even some places. Here in Hong Kong, you are here. You don't want to be identified as a Christian. Amen?
Amen.
You don't want to identify that as you are managers. Everybody here, they know you. But that part of Hong Kong, nobody knows you there. And you don't want to show that you are a Christian. Because of the benefits you want to get from that area. Amen? Can we turn to Proverbs 29, verse 25? Proverbs 29, verse 25. If you are there, you read.
Proverbs 29, verse 25. Fear of man will prove to be a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord is kept safe.
Amen. Whoever trusts in the Lord, keep safe. Because that man you are not afraid. Not that I am afraid of this man. I just fear, you know. You have the fear that if you declare who you are, that you will not get the benefit. That is it. Then number seven. One of the bad side. Peter sat down with the officers and the servants of the high priest to warm himself at their fire. You know, sometimes, you know, in our life, the kind of company we keep may also contribute for that person's great fall.